Hi, I'm Brett, and today we are continuing our series on linear equations by learning how to construct perpendicular lines. By the end of today's lesson, you'll know how to find the equation for a line that goes through a specific point, but is perpendicular to a given line. So for this example, we are going to construct a line that passes through the point 1, 4 and is perpendicular to the line negative 4x plus 2y equals 10. Now whenever you're trying to make an equation of a line, you need a couple pieces of information. You either need two points that the line goes through or you need a point and the slope. So in this problem, we're given the point and we're told that the line will be perpendicular to this line. So we can use the information here to figure out what the slope of our new line should be. The first thing I need to do though is figure out the slope of the line that they give me. So I'm going to take this equation and solve for y so that I can easily read off the slope from slope-intercept form. So from this equation, I now know that the slope of this line is 2. And because I want to create a perpendicular line, I'm going to take the negative reciprocal of this. So recall that the negative reciprocal simply means that I change the sign. So since this is positive, my new slope will be negative, since this one's positive. And I'm going to flip the fraction upside down. When it's written as a whole number, remember that you can create a fraction out of it by writing it over top of 1. So the reciprocal, or the flipped version of this, will be 1/2. That means that the slope that we want to work with our new equation will be negative 1/2. Now I'm just going to plug in the slope and this point into the point slope formula. Recall that in point slope formula, the slope is m, and the point that we want to plug in will replace the x1 and y1. Next, I'm just going to solve for y so that I can get it in slope-intercept form, which will make it really easy to graph from in our final step. Y equals negative 1/2 x plus 4.5 will be the equation of the line that is perpendicular to our original line. And of course, to demonstrate that, we are going to graph both our original line and our perpendicular line on the same coordinate axis. So to graph our first line, I'm simply going to start by marking the y-intercept, which is at positive 5. Then I'm going to apply a slope of 2, which is really 2 over 1. And remember, the numerator represents our rise or our change in y, and the denominator represents our run or change in x. So from this point, I can go up 2 and right 1. I'm running out of room here, so what I'm going to do is the exact opposite to fill in a couple more points. I'm going to go down 2 and left 1, and that will give me more points on the plane. Lastly, we're just going to add the graph of y equals negative 1/2 x plus 4.5 onto our coordinate plane. So I'm going to start by marking the y-intercept, which is at 4.5. So I'm just going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm just going to go halfway and mark it. Next, I'm going to apply a slope of negative 1/2, which means I go down 1 and right 2, or alternately, I can go up 1 and left 2. And what we have here is two lines that intersect in a right angle. So the degree measure between these two lines will be 90 degrees, and that is our definition of perpendicular. There's a lot more tutorials like this over on the Math Hacks channel, so hop on over there and check it out. Till next time, I'm Brett, and good luck studying.